Hey everybody, it's Invicta. It's time to resume the character runs here in the Binding of Isaac Victor Rebirth series. Thank you everyone who's been watching the series thus far. And this is your spoiler warning for the previous episode. If you've not seen it, please pause this video and go watch it now, because in 3 seconds I will be spoiling it for you. Go do it. You have the count till, well, 15 seconds into the video and then I spoil it. You're going to pause now or forever be spoiled. So we got an Eden win. Thank you very much indeed. I will gladly take an Eden win. Today we're going to be playing as Azazel, pretty much the most anticipated character run yet. We just got done doing a Samson run when we were doing the character runs. It went Blue Baby. We did a Blue Baby, which was entitled Blue Redo. I thought that was a pretty clever title. And then we had Eve, which was Try, and then Samson, which was 180. That incredible run. If you haven't seen the 180 run, which is episode 12, I highly suggest watching it at some point. But we are going to be going to Azazel, or Azazel. Somebody very close to me once told me that I pronounce it incredibly badly. Incredibly badly is also not an English phrase, but I'm going to pretend it is. And we get Pyromaniac right off the bat, which is 99 bombs. So at the very least, our bomb situation is null and void. We will not have any bomb issue. Now let's talk about Azazel before we get started rocking and rolling in here. He is what some people consider as an overpowered alter ego of Isaac. And I think that that's a fair assessment to make. I mean, let's be honest, if you have a character that starts with mini brimstone and flying, I'd say you may have an argument there. I personally don't think he's overpowered, especially since that he does start out with no red hearts. But the simple fact that, yeah, he does have brimstone, and oh yeah, he can also fly, it's nice to have a powerful character for once. I mean, coming from a Blue Baby run, we're gonna bomb everything, by the way. Ooh, is that Fate? I think it is Fate. Wow, so we do get Fate, which is the unlock after beating Blue Baby with Blue Baby. So, and we do get, excuse me, do get Nickel. And by the way, I'm still recovering from my fever that I had from traveling. Looking for the super secret room here. There it is. And Eternal Heart. All right, we'll take it. Good start. Fate gives you flying, by the way, and an Eternal Heart. Of course, we didn't need flying because we're Azazel. And apologies if I am, you know who you are, by the way. If I am mispronouncing Azazel's name, I do apologize. I'm not doing it. I'm not doing it on purpose. I'm just simple. I'm just a simple person. I like my sandwiches with just bread and meat and cheese. That's it. I don't need any of those nasty vegetables. I like my pizzas plain with cheese. And I'm quite a simple, boring person. I also don't know how to pronounce things properly. That's okay. Azazel, one of the most requested alter egos of Isaac to be seen in the Rebirth series. Yes, indeed. Almost getting to 15 cents. I'm sure we could find another 2 cents here somewhere. At the very least, we could probably bomb the donation machine if we truly need it. So we're going up against Gurglings, which is a not a favorable matchup of mine. I need to play this as if I didn't get the Eternal Heart. So I'm going to play this as if I'm trying to protect an Eternal Heart right now. Now again, one benefit of being Azazel here against Gurglings is that we do not have to worry about the creep since we are flying. And there you go. And look at that. We even get ourselves the Torn Photo, which is going to be giving us a huge, huge increase to tiers. Meaning that our mini brimstone is going to charge super fast. That will be the pill jar, I believe, which lets you hold on to more than 2 pills at a time, or more than 1 pill at a time. Not going to do it. I'm going to buy this spirit heart, and I think we call it a day. And as you can see, my donation machine has been tapped quite a few times since the last time you've seen it. I have been playing Isaac off stream, off camera, because I absolutely love this game. So let us get into basement 2 here. 2 cursed chests, okay, and 2 pills. And neither one of them are good. So, you know what? I am going to use the full card here just so I don't take any damage. And again, having Pyromaniac means that we can explore pretty much every single room/secret room that we want, which makes us inherently more powerful. It's secondarily making us powerful because of the fact that we do get to bomb anything that we want. We are in no danger of running out of bombs at all. There we go. So there's our, I think this is our, is this our super secret room? I don't, this might be our regular secret room. So we can bomb our way into the shop, I believe, or the library, whatever this is. Interesting. Interesting. I'm gonna come out of this door just so it's open. And we are at 15 cents again. So here's our shop. And, whoa, careful there, Dingle. Yeah, Dingleberry. Well, I mean, we could spend 7 cents and get 5 more bombs, but let's be frank, I don't think we really need the bombs. Alright, super secret room can't possibly be here. There's a tinted rock, very nice. Oh man, no spirit rock, and a, or a spirit heart and a bomb. Box of spiders, not very good, but it's better than nothing, I guess. So what box of spiders is, it's just, it's literally, it's the it's quite honestly the most literal tooltip explanation in any game ever. The tooltip literally just says it's a box of spiders. It's perfect. Super secret room has a lot of red hearts. Alright. Maybe we can get Dark Bum? Maybe? I don't know. Double red Monstro. What did I do to deserve this? Maybe the game just doesn't like us playing as Azul. That's possible. That was terrible damage. That's okay. See how fast that we can charge up our Brimstone, and they dropped an Eternal Heart. Well, thank you. Thank you, Double Monstro. Tears and shot speed up again. Use the Shadow. If we take that, it will kill us. So, and I wouldn't take it anyway, even if I did have the HP. And we're done. I'll be much happier when I can shake this cold. Let's go into the curse room and see what we got. 2 curse chests. Alright. Mob trap room is going to have a bunch of money, which I will take. So talking about my audio issues, I've recently discovered that it's actually possibly going to be my headset and not my motherboard. I have yet to confirm it. I just talked about it on stream a couple days ago. But I noticed something weird happened. So, long story short, wow, that's more terrible damage. Long story short, I ended up wiring up the front panel of my case. Normally, I do not wire my front panel audio on my computer. Just basically, without getting too nerdy on you, I just don't do it. Let's put it that way for some reasons. The audio issue has been bugging me enough to where, like, I just needed to find out, okay, is it my actual motherboard or is it the headset? And what I found out was that after hooking up, this is going to be Infestation 2, which is actually quite good for Brimstone. Basically, what Infestation 2 does, it will spawn attack flies or attack spiders off of everything that we kill. So combine that with the box of spiders, and man, oh man, we're going to be having lots. Lots of attack spiders that are also going to be scaling with our Brimstone, by the way. You know what? I'm not gonna bomb those. Lots of money. So anyway, I hooked up the front panel audio, and the microphone, to my surprise, was doing the same thing. Now, for those of you who don't know too much about computers or just a general not a nerd, the front panel audio has nothing to do with your rear. Depending on the motherboard and case, normally it does not have anything to do with your rear audio jacks. Meaning that the fact that the problem has persisted after me switching the audio panel indicates to me that it is indeed not a motherboard problem, but the microphone itself. So right now I'm currently still using the microphone. Yeah, we'll take the blue map. We'll take it. I don't know if this is a tinted rock. It kind of looks like one. This one also kind of looks like one. And it was. Look, one of them looked like one, okay? You know, getting real sick of these all red heart rooms game. Wow, so much money, man. You know what, I'm going to pay back. I've tapped the donation machine so much. I feel bad. We're going to... All right, well, never mind. I tried. I tried to give my best, and my best wasn't good enough. I am interested in seeing what's in that library room as well. Our attack spiders do so much damage, man. So anyway, the microphone, the audio problems persisted. after I switched the audio panels. Oh, Dark Bum, are you kidding me, game? And we have that red heart room full of red hearts. Oh, this is going to be beautiful. Welcome, Dark Bum. Let's see what these are. Range up. Hey. We'll take it. Dark Bum recently got nerfed, by the way. He's still quite good. They nerfed the amount of red hearts that he needs before he starts paying out in spirit hearts. But he's still the premier go-to carry support pretty much item in the game. There you go. And by the way, if you don't know what Dark Bum does, he turns red hearts on the ground into spirit hearts, depending on how many he picks up. And we hit the jackpot here. It's quite funny that I said, oh, it'd be nice if we got Dark Bum, and then here we are. So watch the... Oh, yeah, he can't do that from here. He has to go outside. There we go. Even dropped an evil heart. Thank you, Dark Bum. Now, we have an opportunity here to go for a boss rush kill if I want to. And that might be something that we may do. I'm just going to try to cut down some of the time here. So we could possibly, ooh, so it's a reroll room, but I don't know what the six dice does. I think it rerolls your items, but I'm not sure. That's something that I haven't looked up yet. So I recently found out that the numerical value of the dice on the ground determines what it rerolls, and that's something I did not know. I'm still learning. This is only episode, I think, 15 now. So there's still plenty to learn for myself in the Binding of Isaac Rebirth. Check our curse room. It's two evil hearts. That's beautiful. Whoa. Now, we could use damage. That was some awful damage, by the way. Speaking of damage. Damage is something that we do not have, but as you can see, Azazel's shot is slightly longer. We've only had two range upgrades. Take that. More bombs. Yippity-doo-dah. So where am I going with the audio issue? Well, right now I'm currently having a temporary audio fix. I'm using a USB sound card, which is god-awful, but it's working. But you're going to hear... Ooh, Smartfly is so good. You're going to hear some crackling and popping in the audio, and I do apologize. And I realize that some of the balance is a little bit off as well. It's just that's the way it has to be until I can replace my headset. Could get a half-price key here. I don't think there's any harm in doing that. Was that the battery, actually? It was the battery. I'll take it. Boomerang. Not a huge fan of boomerang. So what the battery does is it will store energy and actually continually recharge items. It's basically one... On the one room charge items, it will automatically recharge it, which is pretty nice. Mega Fatty is not going to have a good time here. I really don't like Mega Fatty. I think I've said that before already, but yeah, not a fan of Fatty. That little quick jump he does is quite terrifying. It's gonna be Mega Maw, huh? We can just rattle off some Brimstone shots. Look at that. Thank you, Revenge Fly. Wasn't worth it. That's okay. We're just gonna look for the boss room here. I will go into our super secret room in the case that there might be like an eternal heart or something in there. Maybe a deal with the angel item in there. There's an evil heart. We'll take it. There, Junior. Welcome to the show. Oh, this is so good. We get so many attack spiders from there. We'll go get our tarot card. So I am going to be going for a boss rush kill if I can. Ooh, Dark One. This one's not going to be as fun as I wish. Who's darker, Azazel or Dark One? I think they're both equally dark. Thank you, Smartfly. There you go, Dark Bum. Another range upgrade. Thank you, Dark Bum. Showing off why he is amazing. The Nail, Ceremonial Robes. Ceremonial Robes gives us evil up. I don't think there's any point in taking that, though. Even though evil up is... I mean, it's a good... It looks cool, and it's a good item. It's just not really what we want. Two spirit hearts. We actually have more spirit hearts than we can handle right now. And spiders. I'm looking for damage. Really damage is what we want right now. I think that's a Tinted Rock. It's not a Tinted Rock. I take that back. I stand corrected. I'll take Pinky Eye. I don't think it actually... It may work with Mini Brimstone. I'm not actually sure. We just have our... We have our 10 Spider Hit Squad going right now. I'm looking to... I did get a very generous fan donation. And I don't usually talk about this kind of stuff on YouTube. But I did get a generous fan donation who was interested in helping me replace the cost of the motherboard. If it turns out that the motherboard is not the culprit, which I'm now pretty sure it's not, then that money will be going towards replacing the microphone or my headset. And I'm actually not going to go. I'm actually not going to replace it with another headset mic. I think I'm just going to go for a desktop microphone at this point, and then just use my earbuds from my iPhone. A lot of people do that. I know that Day9 does it. A lot of other people use like a really good studio quality desktop microphone, and then they just use. I mean, you don't need fancy speakers to hear. I sleep with my iPhone buds in my ear, so like it's, I have no problem about that. Oh. So again, right now, what do we have going for us? Well, obviously our health. We will probably never die in this run, but we need damage. That's the biggest thing. I was kind of really hoping that Cricket's head or Max's head, something was in there. Polyphemus would be amazing with the adversary, which I'm not too happy about. But unfortunately for him, he spawns spiders, and if he spawns spiders and I kill them, then guess what? They turn into our spiders. So that's the reason why I don't like the adversaries, because of that homing brimstone that he does, and then this little charge. He does this leap. Another range upgrade, really? Good lord, man. It's a lot of range upgrades. I actually don't recall if we... Did we get the item room from the last floor? I don't remember. Oh, wow. Whoa! Shovel is not something that we're going to be doing. As funny as that would be. Yeah, we're not going to be doing that. Two pills. Spirit heart. More pills. More pills. Good lord, man. Alright, so Mooncard takes us to the secret room. Speed up. I'm okay with speed up on Azazel. Luck up. It's whatever. Tears down. That's not good. So I'm gonna use our secret, our Mooncard right away. See if this gets us any closer to the boss room. Which it doesn't look like it did. So... There's two more pills. Good lord, man. Speed down, alright. This has been a very kooky run so far. Another golden key. Man, oh man, what is going on right now in this run? Pinky Eye does indeed stack with Mini Brimstone. That's pretty nifty. If I were a boss, I'd be up here. More spiders. Might as well nuke them so I get my spiders. Where are my spiders at? Where are my spiders at? Infestation's so good. All I'm really looking for is damage. So this will give us plus one keys. Mom's key is less is now more. I mean, you can never have too many keys. We'll just go like blow it up. Even though we do need a trinket, again, I'm kind of in boss rush mode right now. We've got 3.5 minutes to get to the next. Or no, actually, this is the mom floor. So we will be doing a boss rush. I don't know how well we're gonna do with our base damage of Azazel. Cartridge is not very good. So it's gonna be regular mama. But I think with Mini Brimstone plus Infestation, we should be okay. Again, our base damage is still just base damage. The spiders help out a lot, but obviously our survivability is going to come from Darkbone, and we're just not going to die. So I could take the negative, which would send us down to I believe the Lamb. But right now I need a blue baby kill on Azazel. So the Mulligan. Mulligan is super good for what we need. I don't know what this is. This one, it's not Aquarius. I don't remember what this one is either. But yeah, I have to take the Mulligan. The Mulligan is just too good for Brimstone. It will consistently shoot flies. If we can get something like the Hive Mind or something, that'd be amazing. Gotta be careful, Blighted Ovum. Super careful. And again, since we have Dark Bum, this is gonna be easy peasy for us because he's just gonna be all these bosses. Well, not all of them, but some of them do drop hearts, which means that Dark Bum's just gonna consistently pay us out with Spirit Hearts and possibly Evil Hearts. Speaking of heart, there's carrying Queen's heart. Look at that. Look at Smartfly go, man. He's tearing her up. Tearing her up. See you later. There's Duke of Flies. This is good for us because we'll just keep spawning more spiders. Dark Bum didn't pay out. That's okay. Again, we're in no danger of dying. There we go. More hearts dropped by the bloat. Got tagged by Blastocyst, who really cares? This is not going to be a finesse kill. This is just we're just going to go through the motions here and wreck shop. There's Loki. By the way, the music for the boss rush room is absolutely phenomenal. Actually, the entire music soundtrack in Rebirth is just so good. Everything about Rebirth is great. It's certainly in my running, if not a lock, for Sinvicta's number one game of 2014. There you go. Unlock the Cellar. I don't know exactly what unlocked that, but because we're not done with the we're nowhere near done with the boss rush. Got all the spirit hearts, man. Our spiders and our revenge fly is just gonna go ham and cheese on everything. Since it's already aggroed, like it's just gonna be nothing but aggro on all these bosses. It's just madness. Outside of Rebirth, what would be my other top considerations for game of the year? In 2014, I'd say Shadow of Mordor, definitely. What hit us there? I'm not quite sure what hit us. Maybe it was a fly I couldn't see, I don't know. Shadow of Mordor, I have to give consideration to. Civilization Beyond Earth was still really, really good. I haven't played it in a while, but that was certainly up there. What are the games that I played in 2014? That came out in 2014, I mean. I'm not sure. I don't normally get too many new games when they come out anymore. Gotta be careful, Monstro here. But again, Dark Bum is just tanking us through all this. We're not having any problems. I'd say Shadow Mordor and Civilization Beyond Earth is probably rounds out my top three with Rebirth. But Rebirth, hands down, is my game of 2014. It's already one of my favorite games of all time. And the game is not, the game's still quite new. I haven't even begun to unlock everything in the game. I think it's well documented. Thank you, Pin, for all those spiders. Well documented how much Sinvicta loves him some Binding of Isaac. We're taking a lot of damage. Admittedly, I'm being really reckless right now just because I know that we can't die. So I'm not really too worried about it. I know I might be a little bit lazy here, but like I said, with Dark Bum, we are in literally no danger of dying. Let's put it this way. It's gonna be impressive if I actually die in this run. That will be quite impressive. Even for my terrible standards, it would be very impressive if we ended up dying in this run. Now again, our damage is our biggest weak spot right now. We do not have that good of damage. The Mulligan is certainly helping, along with Infestation 2. But our base damage is, we have yet to have a damage increase. Come on, Famine. Get him a revenge fly, get him. I think Death and War should be the last two here. Oh man, that smart fly is epileptic seizure warning there. Where are you going, War? It's Black War too, which is a little bit problematic. Not all that terribly scary, however. I just My favorite thing about the Boss Rush room, other than the amazing music and just that it's a lot of fun, is that the room just gets completely messed up. Like, look at the ground. Just what a mess. What an absolute mess. Fallen. Oh, yeah. Headless Horseman and Fallen are the last ones, I believe. I forgot. I knew that we were missing one. I didn't know, but I felt like we were missing one. I think Revengefly already took out one of the Fallens, yeah. Revengefly going ham, man. We got hot bombs, which was, needless to say, not worth it. Let's see if there are there any more hearts that Dark Bum hasn't picked up yet. Yeah, there's one here. And we're going to go down to the next level. Very fun indeed. I love me the boss rush. Curse of Lost, not too happy about seeing this, but that's okay. Getting Hive Mind would still be great here. And again, we're still working with base Azazel damage, which suffice to say is not that much. Which is the reason why I picked up the Mulligan, was because that is going to help out our damage. And we get Infamy, which is just going to boost our defensive capabilities, but as you see here, we don't have to do much damage on Azazel. We'll just let our attack flies and attack spiders do the work for us. Again, if I can one-shot the Azazel kill on Blue Baby and Isaac, that's ideal. I know that we probably have a good shot at getting like a lamb kill, but honestly, I've never even seen the fight before, let alone have like done it. So yeah. I'm not in a hurry to unlock things in the Binding of Isaac. I'm just not. I don't want to ruin the game by like me going, "Oh, I've just got to I have to be the first to unlock everything," sort of thing. Like I don't want to do that. The game is too precious to me to want to do that. I can understand the appeal of someone saying that, "Hey, you know, I want to be the first to show off this new weapon combination, or I want to be the first to beat, you know, Super Satan or whatever he's called." But that's not me. I don't like rushing through things. I like taking my time. I'll take a speed up here. Even though we're already quite fast, I don't think it's going to really matter all that much. That said, I think this is about the fastest that I would like to go. Champion Diglett. Thank you, Dark Bum. One more, buddy. There you go. Come on, attack spiders. Get in there and beat somebody. We don't really need the lockpick. Do we go this way? I think there was... Apparently not. Wasted a key there. I don't think it really matters. I'd be forgiven for saying that this is probably a one run. Again, I don't see it there being any possible way that I die in this, thanks to Dark Bum. Even after the nerf, Dark Bum is still quite good. Now these guys are also quickly becoming my most annoying enemies in the game. Still think that we stick with we're gonna stick with Pinky Eye until we get something better, because we need anything that augments our base damage, and poison shots definitely help. Even though it doesn't directly augment our base damage, it certainly helps. This speed up again, good lord man, I don't need to go that fast. Dark Bombs is gonna have a field day, man. Oh man, so many hearts, man. Tears down and luck up, sure. Alright, Dark Bum, replace my spirit heart. Another one over here, buddy. Imagine if we had Hive Mind. Hive Mind, by the way, makes bigger spiders and bigger flies. So, yeah. Just imagine if we had that for a second. Getting some nice energy there with Mulligan, the Box of Spiders, and Infestation, too. I think it's kind of ironic that we got that sort of weird synergy, because I'm not a huge fan of Box of Spiders, but right now it's doing work for us. Mama Gertie, thanks for coming out. Good to see you. Fortunately, it's not your day today. If we didn't have flying, that flight would be absolutely horrible. Experimental treatment. And Blimstone! I mean, it's not gonna kill us if I take it, so I might as well just go all out and just finish. Now we're the embodiment of the real form of Azazel now. I don't know what the experiment did, excuse me. I'm not quite sure what the experiment did. It doesn't seem like we've gotten any slower. In fact, it seems like we've gotten faster. I don't know how our base damage has changed, if any, though. It's possible that we could have gotten a lot stronger. It's possible we could have gotten a lot weaker. But Brimstone plus anything in Rebirth is quite good. I don't think we need to fight that. This is going to be a Stars card. Okay. Takes us to the item room, which, of course, there's no more item rooms in the game. Brimstone plus the Mulligan is quite hilarious. I'll touch Mr. Boom just to get it out of the equation here. Wow, we are super fast right now. Super duper fast. And Judgment! Good to see you, Judgment. I would love an HP upgrade. That would be a bomb. That would be a key. That would be a red heart. Again, preferably... Oh, well, I guess. I mean... I suppose. I'm not gonna poo-poo a gift horse in the mouth here. Which sounds entirely inappropriate. I promise it didn't come out the way. That's not the literal meaning that I meant there. Figuratively speaking, I'm not going to look a gift horse in the mouth, let alone poo-poo in their mouth. We have so many spiders and flies and tigers and bears. Oh my, there's an arcade here. Don't really care about the arcade. Unless there's is there a donation machine in there? There is not. There is a demon judgment and a regular judgment. We'll just continue to donate here. That'll be a bomb. That'll be Luckfoot. Which I guess. Another judgment. What's going on, man? Three judgments in a row? There's my HP upgrade. Now, for those of you scratching your heads, figuring out why, Sinvicto, why would you ever want an HP upgrade at this point? Well, my fellow nerds... Because of one simple fact. There might be a deal with the devil item that we may want. You never know. We could get a Joker card that gives us something like, Proptosis would be cool. I don't think I'd take Dead Cat. I think if I did take Dead Cat, it would take away all of our Spirit Hearts and Evil Hearts. So, needless to say, that would be slightly counterintuitive. It's always good to have red hearts, though. It's your failsafe. If anything, say for example, if like Guppy's paw drops or something, and you get in a bind, then you can give yourself, you know, three more spirit hearts in an emergency sort of thing. Oh man, Darkbone's gonna have a field day with that. I have so many spiders. This is just silly. Love myself some Brimstone. Brimstone plus Mulligan equals LOLOLOL. So, It Lives is not going to have a fun time. He's not going to be going bowling tonight, that sort of thing. We're just going to build up our attack flies, get in there. There we go. Gotta say, it's some pretty impressive dodging that we did there towards the end. It's a spirit heart I can't get, and we're just going to go up. Rocking and rolling on Azazel, man. Now, if I were Isaac, I would probably be to the... I don't know. My gut reaction tells me southwest. That's some cheap shots, game. The game got angry at me for saying that I actually did a decent job dodging for once. It's all right. It's understandable. Going on greed. First greed of the day. Whoa! Steam sale. Well, thank God we got that steam sale. Yes, I will be very happy when I don't have this cough anymore. Thank you for asking. You can't tell, but I'm trying to subdue the coughing reflex as much as I can right now. Sometimes it works, sometimes it gets a little too unbearable. I don't really get sick all that much, but when I do, man, it's bad. If you know it's bad if I get sick. I was correct in my prediction. And by the way, if you take a look at the box of spiders right now, that is the battery overcharging it. You saw there briefly before I hit the space bar. Before I so rudely hit the space bar. And the battery was... Oh, you're fine. So good. The battery was overcharging box of spiders. Take the stars card just in case. I wish I could take it, Dark Bum. Maybe after the Isaac fight. Maybe I'll come back for that. We also have Infamy, which means that we're not going to take a whole lot of damage from the front. Where's Revenge Fly? How come Revenge Fly hasn't activated yet? There you go. Get in there, Revenge Fly. Oh, Isaac. Don't do that, man. Do not appreciate that. I probably could be using bombs here, but I think that would just put me in harm's way, to be honest. Oh! You gotta stop doing that, Isaac. You're scaring the kids, man. There we go. So we unlocked the Satanic Bible, whatever that is. Gonna go back and get the Spirit Heart. Actually, there's a secret room here. Let's find out what the super secret room is. Counterfeit penny. Needless to say, we won't be taking that. And yeah, that was a super duper easy peasy Isaac kill. So we've got Isaac out of the way on Azazel. Now we've got to go for Blue Baby. Blue Babby. We can knock out a lot of things here. Alright. The bean. Not quite sure what that is. Black bean. Halo flies. I have no idea what this item is. Cancer. HP up. Feel protected. I'm not going to take the bean, but I think cancer gives you a damage shield, and also it revives you with one heart if you die, I think. I'm actually okay with taking the black bean there. After this room, I am going to use the Stars card just to see where it puts us. It's not going to take us to our secret room. It would take us to the item room in a normal floor. All right, let's find out where it takes us. It will take us to the same exact floor that we were in, or same exact room that we were in, so cheers to that. Thank you, Stars card. You can summon all the spiders you want there, Big Daddy. I will happily convert your spiders over to my way of life. This room is just a complete nightmare. Luckily, we're okay. I have no idea if I'm going the right way or not. I'm not a huge fan of seeing the bloat here, but that's okay. We got the Brimstone, we've got Infestation 2, we got the Mulligan, so we're okay. This room also is quite the nightmare, in more ways than one. This room is quite awful indeed. I think there's like 10 dingles in here. It's amazing that the health bar is even attuned to have this many bosses on the same screen. And you can calculate exactly where, what position the meter needs to be. So Blue Baby was not down here. I have a feeling he's gonna be up to the right. But I am gonna check the super secret room just in case there's a bunch of red hearts in there. It never hurt to be safe. I don't know exactly what hit us there. I thought the room was clear game, but apparently not. Double super gluttony. Sometimes scary. Especially when he takes stupid damage like that. Thank you, double super gluttony. Well, I wonder if he'll pick up... No, he won't pick up an Eternal Heart. That's probably good. Probably by design. You know what? I'm going to play this for Spirit Hearts. And possibly a good trinket, possibly a good tarot card. So That's two diamonds, so we can double our money. Emperor, that's going to take us to Blue Baby. Two of clubs, double our bombs. We're back up to 99 bombs again. I don't like either of these. I'm not going to take Mom's toenail for that exact reason. Thank you, game. That's about the cheapest of cheap shots right there. Matchstick. Getting lots of bicycle cards. Crystal ball. Might as well. Not going to take whip shot. There's the Joker card I was waiting for. So, Joker card it is. Let us go. It's going to be Krampus. Well, hopefully he drops Lump of Coal here. That would be a nice, timely pickup of Lump of Coal right in the chest. We got Whipworm. I didn't really want Whipworm, but whatever. Lump of Coal. Nice. Very, very nice. All right, so now we can take Pinkie Eye. Where's our Emperor card? There we go. And yeah, let's do this. So again, there's nothing real special about Blue Baby in Rebirth. He does have a little bit of a dangerous mechanic where he starts, in Phase 3, he starts flying around, actually moving while shooting, which is a little bit scary, but for the most part, the fact that he summons adds and the fact that we have Infestation 2 is really working, is going to be working against him. Plus, those adds that he spawns can also drop hearts, and yeah, Dark Bum, MVP of the entire year NA. Doesn't even matter what year you're watching this. If you watch this 2014, 2015, hell, you might be watching this 2016, man. Doesn't matter. Dark Bum is still the official MVP of this year. And we're going to get a super easy-peasy Blue Baby kill here on Azazel. So we knocked out a lot of unlocks with that one. Thank you, Dark Bum, and thank you for watching. We just unlocked Abaddon, and I'm okay with that. Thank you for watching, everyone. I hope you enjoyed it. See you next time here on the channel for more The Binding of Isaac. So long, everybody.